Happy Arm Day to all those who celebrate.
Yeah, I was just trying to formulate this idea. And, you know, we've been waiting for this moment in many ways for several years now. This time when ARM-based computers would actually make sense. Mm-hmm. And, you know, ignoring the Windows RT thing, although maybe we shouldn't. You know, the goal starting with Windows 10 was that we were going to have these always connected PCs. That was the point. We're going to make PCs behave more like mobile devices, right? All the goodness that that entails. Mm-hmm. Included connectivity, like 5G connectivity, right? And then Microsoft got the AI bug. And now we have something called Copilot Plus PCs because we need yet another brand that's going to be temporary. And they removed the 5G connectivity requirement. These things are not always connected PCs, although, I mean, we'll eventually see 5G on some of these things, obviously. But for now, they're pushing the AI. And last second, the marquee. Look, there were only, how many Copilot Plus specific AI features ship in the OS? Five? We're not talking 50 here, right?
No,
that's the point. So it, you know, the whole thing's been kind of undermined, right? And some of it's just bad marketing. Some of it is just too much too soon in the case of AI. Some of it is the controversy around recall, obviously, which I don't feel is deserved in the slightest. All kinds of things, but you know, it's just a shame.
Yeah,
you know. Yeah. It should have been better.
They're here. I wouldn't say loud. That's hopefully what
I hope they're not loud. That would be the opposite. Yeah, quiet and proud.
Quiet and proud would be the optimal.
Yeah, sort of. That does seem to be the case, by the way. I mean, based on briefings I've had with companies, and based on even the early people have gotten some for some reason that, you know, early benchmarks aren't great or whatever. Most of them. They're quiet. They go about their way quietly. You know.
Yeah. We'll see. You know, time will be the true arbiter here to see what the hell happens. Because,
right.
Like, things are done. Things are shipping.
Mm-hmm.
There is sort of an odd split, though, that has occurred. It'll get rectified eventually. But, like, 24H2 is now this sort of enigma that we all are getting.
Yeah. I think this one's misunderstood a little bit. And probably by me too. I don't mean to say like I have the answer. I'm sorry. I think it's confusing, maybe is the better way to say it. Because anyone could right now go install the latest Insider ISO from the release preview and then without assigning their PC, without enrolling, and you know, upgrade, and then use Windows Update to update to the latest build, which is the shipping version of 24H2 that is going out to Copilot Plus PCs, and you're unstable. Like you'll get stable updates every 4 weeks or every two, if that's what you want. If you want the preview updates, you'll get those too. But you know, the release notes for that latest build, the first stable 24H2 build, the one that went out over the weekend, says it's only available for Copilot Plus PCs. And it's like, and also no, right? So if you want it, it's there. This was always going to be weird, though, right? I mean, I think here's the confusion. I'm sorry. This is the stumbling block I have with this. I think this was always the way it was going to be. I don't think they actually changed anything. I think people are looking at that little note about Copilot Plus PCs and are saying, oh, now they're limiting it to these Copilot Plus PCs. I'm like, I don't think that's the case. I think this was always meant to be like this. So we'll, you know, I don't know. Here's, and maybe the underlying truth here that maybe is the most important one is, as of yesterday, or the other day, or last week, or however you want to say it, 23H2, 22H2, both in stable, both supported, both identical. They're just different bills, but they're the same exact thing. If you have a non-Copilot Plus PC and you update to 24H2, that's actually not the case, right? There are actually Oh, I'm sorry. That's not true. I was going to say there are features that are unique to 24H2, but those are coming to stable. So those are coming to 23H2 and 22H2. So as of today, if you want to see those things early, you can get 24H2 the way I described earlier. But if you wait, they're coming to you. Like the stuff that's in 24H2 today on non-Copilot Plus PCs will be in stable on 22H2 and 23H2 too. So going forward, these things are in lockstep, and then 22H2 disappears in October, and we'll still have the two. I think these things are always going to be. I think this is the temporary new way of doing things. It's kind of weird. It's so hard to keep track of this stuff.
Yeah, I was about to say.
And I live this. Like this is my half of my point these days. But I still confusing. I could really do it with a little bit of stability and a little less chaos, you know?
Yeah. Still wonder if they would have called this Windows 12, what would have happened? I mean, we know why they don't. I don't want to go down that rabbit hole, but it's like...
Yeah, well, except for one thing, I would say this whole recall thing would have been a bigger nightmare if they had called this Windows 12. Yeah, imagine that controversy undermining a major new release of Windows. That would have been a huge problem. The other thing to imagine, I guess, is if Microsoft simply did recall the way that Apple did Apple Intelligence, or is doing it, right? Which is to announce in May, ship these things, well, in this case, they're shipping much earlier than Apple, but ship the new PCs in June, I guess, with whatever set of features. And then, really the real final release is in October-ish, whatever it is. And in the holiday season, you go into that with Copilot Plus PCs across all the different platforms, right? That thing should be called or could be called Windows 12, and it would make some sense, you know? But, just like you would call it iOS 18, Microsoft's not good at this stuff. To be fair to them, it's not really obvious what's better or whatever. But whatever we get, it's going to be confusing.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what they're going to do.
I know.
I know.
What do you do next? I don't know.
Yeah, because AI was the thing that could have... Whatever. I'm sure they'll come up with something.
But then again, right? So I complain. Complain's the wrong word. I point out, that there are only a handful of unique features on these Copilot Plus PCs. That it's okay, right? Two points there. One is this stuff's brand new anyway. I mean, what did you think was going to happen, right? But nobody buys Windows or buys a PC to run what's in Windows. You use third-party apps, right? So I think that there's a great ecosystem slide that Qualcomm had with all the different types of apps and all the apps that were native on ARM, which is most of them on their chart anyway. And it's going to be that stuff just works is job one, but B, the AI capabilities coming to Photoshop and Premiere and whatever DaVinci and whatever the DaVinci thing's called, all those apps, right? So you get those AI capabilities in the apps you actually use, right? I mean, I'm looking at my little taskbar here, and Notion has AI built in, Copilot, GitHub Copilot is built into Visual Studio Code if that's what I want. I'm using Affinity Photo, which is actually kind of backwards when it comes to AI, but there are obviously tools there and these types of programs for that stuff, Paint, whatever. So Teams has AI built in. I mean, all this stuff, that's where the AI is going to matter the most. It's important at a platform level to deliver the hardware that can run this stuff effectively on device. And that's what Windows 11, 24H2, or Copilot, whatever the hell it is, Copilot Plus PCs kind of deliver. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the only thing I can think of, at least top of my head, that would make whatever sense is Windows 12 could be more about local than just nebulous cloud AI, right? They do. I don't know.
Yeah. No, I think of it in terms. So I would say the MPU stuff, once the whole world is at 40 plus tops, things are a little different. I mean, we're going to have higher, ratings at some point. I mean, we have these arbitrary hardware requirements already. I mean, we're going to make them. Mm-hmm. We're going to do this again. There's no doubt about it. So
yeah, I think that's going to be the differentiator. If you want 12, you got to have an MPU.
I think that Windows, watching the way this has evolved, I had written this article about this. It's something I almost obsess over, is this notion of the orchestrator that Windows should be. And right now, everything's just hard-coded. It's going to run off the MP or it isn't. You know, that's pretty much all we're doing right now. And in the same way that Microsoft has created this super resolution technology for all versions of Windows, not the one that built for Copilot, but the all version, where, you know, NVIDIA, AMD slash, what are they called? Radeon, whatever, and Intel all have their own upscaling and whatever technologies. And they're like, guys, we're going to do a DirectX version of this. And and we'll use whatever you have under the covers, and it will be great. That's how orchestration of AI should work as well. Mm-hmm. That's what Windows does. So you, as an app, write to this direct AI, what I'll call it, you know, SDK or runtime, whatever the hell it is. And Windows is an orchestrator, understands the workloads and puts them out to the GPU, CPU, MPU, depending on what kind of computer you have. You know, that's the way it should work. The reason it doesn't is because they want to sell PCs, right? So right now they're like, okay, we're going to make this arbitrary requirement, because it's completely arbitrary. They just made some decision and we're like, we're going to use the MPU. I mean, there are advantages to it. Don't get me wrong. And Stevie Batiche made a nice case for that. But I mean, ultimately the real goal here is not to micromanage that kind of thing. You know, that's what Windows does. It's like, it handles your RAM. It handles the organization of your storage. You don't do that as a person or as an app maker. That's what Windows is for, right? It orchestrates that, to abuse the term. I think that's the future. And maybe that's Windows 12, right? Where we pull in the Copilot stuff and we say, look, we're going to do this for all PCs in a more sophisticated manner. Maybe. Maybe Thursday it changes again. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, at least Adobe is finally getting their day in court, or at least in the limelight for all of
their little... Did you read my thing? Because I just signed up for an Adobe subscription.
Did you?
I just went through that. So the funny, well, I don't funny, but the, I wanted to, I've been experimenting with paid AI services, right? Mm-hmm. So I did Copilot Plus, I'm sorry, ChatGPT Plus for a little while, Gemini, whatever the paid version of that is called. I'm still doing Copilot. I actually I use that all the time. And I found these other things to be not worthless, but I still think the Copilot thing makes the most sense for me. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, all right, well, the big thing I use this for is for images, right? So I'm like, I should obviously look at the Adobe stuff. And it is interesting in this slice of time. Like I just paid for the Affinity stuff late last year. I got it on a great sale. Like it wasn't super expensive, but Affinity Photo is a good app. But if you have imagine you have a photo with some text on it, and you're like, I just want to blow that away. Affinity is horrible for that. Mm-hmm. It's like going back 10 years in time. Even Adobe Photoshop Elements does a great job of that. So I was like, well, let me see, how cheap could I get real Photoshop, you know? And the cheapest is actually something, they have a photography tier where you get Adobe Photoshop and Photoshop Beta. You get the web version and you get Lightroom Classic and the normal version, right? It's $20 a month. I'm like, it's, you know, okay. You can go monthly, you can go yearly, right? So I'm like, I'm going to go monthly. I don't know if I want this thing, you know. But that lawsuit is exactly about what I just did. Because it looks like I went monthly. And it's like, no, you've signed up for a year. You're just going to pay that every month. And it's like, you bastards. Like, you got to be kidding me. So there's a fee they charge you if you try to leave early. Now, I'm in the first 7 days, so I could just leave for free. But for the photography tier, it's not going to be too bad. But if you sign up for full-blown, CC, which is probably, $70 a month or something, I bet they charge you several hundred dollars, right, to try to leave early. So this is why they got sued by the U.S. government. And so last night I went and I said, well, obviously I'm going to cancel this thing. Yep. And they gave me these, deals. Remember, you get Sirius XM and it would be free for a while. It would run out. You're like, I want to cancel. I'm like, oh, you can have it for, next to nothing. They actually did that to me. And I was like, you know what?
They get you.
Even if I have to pay for this for a year, I think, screw it. I'm going to do this. So, I got it for, $14 a month. And honestly, I would have bought a new version of Photoshop Elements this year, which is normally $125. You can kind of get it on sale for $90, $80, whatever it is. And I was like, $14 a month. And I'm like, you know what? Screw it. I'm going to do this. Because I want to use the AI photo stuff, right? Like the photo, image editing.